हेलो चिल्ड्रन, माई सेल्फ मिसेस तनुजा धीरेन याज्ञिक, वी आर गोइंग टू सी द सेकेंड वीडियो ऑफ द लेसन दैट इज द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ द स्वराज. एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट दिस लेसन वी हैड डिवाइडेड इंटू टू वीडियोज एंड इन फर्स्ट वीडियो वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड अबाउट द अष्टप्रधान मंडल ऑफ द स्वराज. Different ministers, their names, their duties we have studied, their designation we had studied, then Shivaji Maharaj's policy regarding agriculture we have studied, and now we are going to study, afterwards we have studied the village economy, and now in the second video we are going to study trade and business of the Swaraj, then military organization we are going to study, intelligence department of Swaraj, then forts, sea forts, navy, and how Shivaji Maharaj having concern for the welfare of his subjects. These points we are going to cover in this video. So let's start with the trade and businesses of the Swaraj. Shivaji Maharaj knew that kingdom does not prosper without in the increase of a business or a trade, because trade brings wealth in the kingdom. As per Shivaji Maharaj in Agyapatra, merchants are the ornaments of the kingdom and glory of the king. Shivaji Maharaj charged heavy duty on the imported goods, thus protecting the local industries such as salt industry in the Konkan. He gave full protection to the local industries or local businesses, and he promoted, he motivated the common businessman so they can increase their businesses, because businessmen, merchants are the glory, they bring wealth in the kingdom. So Shivaji Maharaj gave them proper support and protection in the Swaraj. The military organization, infantry and cavalry were the two main divisions of army. What is infantry and cavalry? Having a proper, in a proper quantity or a proper things, you know, elephants and horses. Okay, these were the army of elephants and horses. That time they were having a big support in the infantry, in the form of infantry and a cavalry, like a army. Hawaldars, zumildars were the officers, and Sir Nobles was the highest officers of the army. Shiledars and Bagirs were the cavalrymen, and Sir Nobles was the highest officer in the cavalry. Who was the highest officer? Sir Nobles. Let's take information about the intelligence department of the Swaraj. Intelligence department collected precise and timely information about the movements of the enemy and submitted it to Maharaj. Bahirji Naik, the head of the intelligence department, gave accurate and detailed information about Surat before the raid. Means Bahirji Naik, who was the head of the intelligence department, and when Shivaji Maharaj was planning to loot the Surat due to the losses, due to secure the loss due to Shaiste Khan invasion, that time proper information about the Surat was given by Bahirji Naik, who was the head of the intelligence department. Forts. Let's take the information about the forts. Forts were of a great importance in the medieval age. Forts helped to keep an eye on the surrounding areas, protected people against foreign invasion, and helped in stocking food grains, ammunition, etc. There were about 300 forts in the Swaraj. Total 300 forts were there. Killedar, Sabnis, Karkhanis were the officials on the every fort. Killedar, each fort was having Killedar, Sabnis and Karkhanis. Shivaji Maharaj was having the prominent quantity of forts, but he was having focus on the sea forts also. It was a view of Shivaji Maharaj that not only land, the sea part of the Swaraj should also protect properly. Maharaj knew the importance of sea forts. He built Sindhudurga Fort at Malwan on the west coast. He built Padmadurga near Rajapur to overshadow the Rajapur of the Siddhi. Let's take information about the navy. To curb the activities of the enemies and to protect the west coast, Maharaj raised a navy. Means to have a proper protection to the west coast, Shivaji Maharaj decided that he is going to increase the navy power. He realized that to control the sea, it is necessary to have a navy. Navy consisted of 400 ships like Gurab, Galbar and Pal, these are the names of battleships. Gurab, Galbar and Pal, these are the names of all battleships. Ships were built at the creek of Kalyan, Bhiwandi, Vijayadurga and Malwan. Mayank Bhandari and Daulat Khan were the chief of naval commanders. Mayank Bhandari and Daulat Khan, these are the names of two officers who were chief of the naval commanders. This is all about the navy. Children, let's take information about the concern for the welfare of his subject. In the beginning, we have studied that Shivaji Maharaj had decided to establish the Swaraj for the common people. His motive was to protect the common people, to develop the common people. So, no foreign power can come in Maharashtra and they can give punishment, or our Maharashtra should not suffer by the foreign powers, was the intention of Shivaji Maharaj for the establishment of the Swaraj. So, basic idea was common people should develop, common people should not suffer unnecessarily, was the concern of Shivaji Maharaj. The main objective of Shivaji Maharaj was to make his subject independent. He was aware that for the subjects to enjoy freedom, disciplined administration, comprehensive care of a people, and protection of conquered territory was necessary. Shivaji Maharaj was a watchful administrator who cared for the common people's welfare. So, Shivaji Maharaj was very much interested to protect the common people, because in the beginning, before the birth of Shivaji Maharaj, as we have studied that Maharashtra was controlled by different powers like Adilshahi, Nizamshahi, Mughal, Portuguese, etc., etc. So, to protect our people from all these enemies was the main concern of Shivaji Maharaj, and that's why he established the Swaraj. This was all about the administration of the Swaraj. In this video, children, let's revise what we have studied in this video. First, we have studied about trade and businesses. Then military organization we have studied. Then we had also taken information about the intelligence department of Shivaji Maharaj. Then we have studied about the forts, navy forts, and why Shivaji Maharaj was having the concern about the welfare of common people, or how Shivaji Maharaj was having concern about the common people, and what were the different activities was done by Shivaji Maharaj for the welfare of his subjects, so that common people can grow in their life, okay, they can live their life independently. This is all about the administration of the Swaraj. After this video, I am going to give you the assignment, children, which we are going to write in your classwork notebook. Till that time, bye-bye. Take care. Stay home. Stay happy. Take care of yourself and your family. Bye-bye.